Good morning, Crossroads South. It is Tuesday, December 14th. It's an A day today. And it's also for School Spirit, it is Decade Day. Now you're probably going, Miss Capes, what decade are you? Well, listen, when you see me, you'll see I've got this on. This reminds me of the 90s. Yeah, 1990. Maybe a little bit into the 2000s, the turn into 1997, 98, 99. There was this whole fashion called grunge, and you'd wear like ripped jeans and flannels, and I probably need like a good choker here, that kind of necklace that just sits right on your neck. Oh my goodness, that was totally the style, and that's what I wore. So that's what I went with. Looking around here, there's tons of decades going through. We've got a lot of 70s, some 60s, some flash dance stuff, some tie-dye. There's a lot. So listen, if you forgot, you're just from this decade. So that works too. It'll be interesting. Hey, here's a little tip, kids. Save your cool stuff now. Save it, pack it in a box. Don't donate it or give it away, because in years to come, your kids are gonna love it. And they're gonna be like, oh my gosh, it's so cool. Or why did you ever wear that? So just save it. That's my statement on that this morning. All right, speaking of school spirit, we are the 12 days countdown. Tomorrow is Wild Wednesday. Anything animal print, animals, you want to wear something fun with animals, whatever it is, Animal Wild Wednesday, that's our theme for tomorrow. If you're thinking ahead, Thursday, Snowman Day, my suggestion is a white shirt with some big black buttons and maybe a scarf. I don't know, maybe somebody will come in with a carrot nose on your mask. Something like that. I don't know. I'm giving you just a few ideas. And then Friday is awesome black and gold day. So we're getting prepared for that. Couple of announcements. I made this announcement yesterday. Sports, we're going to start up our winter sports. I know wrestling has a match on Thursday. Girls basketball has a game on Thursday now. Boys basketball has a game on Friday. So things are getting cooked up. If you are coming to be a spectator, you must go home and come back with an adult. And that adult, whoever you come with, has to stay with you the whole time. They cannot drop you and go. So we're just refining that. You'll need to sign in, say what school you're from and which event you're going to and who's your responsible adult that is here with you. You are welcome to come. We would love to have you here. It just doesn't make any sense for kids to stay after school because you'd be sitting here with nothing to do for a couple of hours based on when the game times start. If things change, we'll let you know, but that's what we're going to start with for right now. Don't forget, those of you who are interested in the musical, your auditions, your audition videos are due, I believe it's by tomorrow, so get that going. If you're not sure, check the VPO, there's a link there. And I'm looking at my notes here, and I think that's everything for right now. Yep, that's everything for right now. So the last thing that I'll share with you is today is Term Tuesday. And Mrs. Ackerson shared with me, this is pretty exciting. I did not know that Dictionary.com and Scholastic did this, but they pick a word of the year. Every year they pick a word of the year. And so I thought for today it would be appropriate to use this year's 2021 word of the year, which is allyship. It's a noun, A-L-L-Y-S-H-I-P. It's the word of the year, and this is the first time ever that the word of the year is also a new word that they've added to the dictionary. So pretty cool that it's both the first time they've chosen a word of the year that is also brand new to the dictionary. So here's the interesting part. Allyship is a noun, and what it means is it's the status or role of a person who advocates and actively works for the inclusion of others, not just as a member of that group, but in solidarity. And you're acting as an advocate for inclusion. And you know what it made me think of is our Unified Vikings program, and all the work that people do there. It's just awesome. Lunch buddies, all those things. So many of you are exhibiting this word of allyship. So I thought that was a great word to use. It comes with the root word of ally, so A-L-L-Y, which is a person who advocates or supports somebody. So, or you're a friend, you can be my ally, and you can align with what I'm thinking and be my support. So that's the word for today. That's our Term Tuesday. Before I have you stand for the salute to the flag, I also want to congratulate our band students last night, the concert band and the two jazz bands and jazz ensemble. Had a phenomenal concert. I wish you could have been there. It was awesome. And by the way, I'm going to give you a little hint. We're going to be in for a treat and hear some of those musicians coming up. I also wanted to tell you that this Friday, we have our very first patterns assembly. Yes, our very first patterns assembly for this school year. If you are new to our school, you don't know what a patterns assembly is yet. It's a whole pep rally that we have to celebrate your reading and your patterns books that you put in. And there are prizes galore, prizes, prizes, prizes for those of you who have read a lot of books and get selected. It's random, so we'll see who our winners are. More to come on that, but that is this Friday during HAP. That now concludes the morning announcements. Please stand for the salute to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Have an awesome day, Crossroads. Bye!